Hello YouTube, it is Damien. It is the Pompey Fire and we are here with you today in episode 5 with a plum tie here in the FA Cup. We are also in the January transfer window and we will be recapping what happens towards the end of this window here today and see if we make any further signings to the squad. In terms of the January transfer window, we've only made the one sale. We sold our left-back Thompson with a year left on his contract just for the thing and seeing what we can do. Anyhow, in our plum tie today, if you have not seen on the screen, I am going to allude to it. We do have Manchester City. It is going to be a really hard game here in the FA Cup round of 32, which is one of the board's things, and away we go. I'm going to be honest here. We actually went through this and then realised that my TV wasn't working properly. And, you know, we tried to fix it and it blacked out. So we're going to have to go through these players again. I know about these players. So like Tyler Walker wasn't that great. Devante Cole, I think, was not great either. It's probably best we do that. Tyler Walker's not great. Callum, I'm scouted because he's Australian. He's not that great as well. But it'll be interesting to see what we can do here. Like Furling's probably someone we should scout with his contract expiring in 6 months' time. Does look okay, does Furling. Prolific striker, probably worth having a look at. Matt Preston, not bad. You know, there's a few players here. I feel like the best way to probably do this is just to go there. Kone, we know about. I think Dimitri is someone that we're going to have a look at next season when he's back from off loan as well, because, you know, he's got 71 overall. The board is going to complain we're not on track. Moussa Barrett also, by the way, is at 20. Looks like quite the signing to you up front. But we're not going to be able to sign any of those players yet because we don't have the money. The board reckons we're not on track, even though, you know, we're top of the table. And we are, you know, we are not on our way to probably meeting the financial, but, you know, we're pretty close to doing the youth development as well. And, you know, we're going to do the domestic success. And if they really want to get upset that we don't sign a crucial striker when we have Ferreira, who's growing and is up front and is doing the business, then so be it. But we'll see what we do in the window anyway. But let's get into this game without further ado here against Manchester City. And away we go. I think our kits are going to cash too much. Like, they got blue, that, and purple. I might put us in, like, a really light colour, like, you know, white, and then get them in the purple. And at least then we're going to be able to tell ourselves apart. We are going to get into this game here. World class is not going to cut it here against Manchester City. I could put it on ultimate, but like that leaves us with no chance. So we're going to put it on legendary and expect to get pumped. 4 minutes, and away we go. If we somehow win on legendary and get another big tire team like Liverpool, for instance, I'll put it on ultimate just to make sure we get smacked. But, you know, on legendary, I would imagine Man City are going to carve us up a new one, considering we lost to Plymouth. But it'll be interesting to see what goes on here. Anyhow, away we go. Shooting bronze. Sure thing, not a problem. We need to be able to shoot well here, Ferreira, if we're going to do anything. And that's not how we're going to shoot. That's not how we want to shoot either. I need to finish one. All right, there we go. That will do. Done. All right. What do you reckon, YouTube? What do you reckon, Twitch chat? What's the score going to be in this one here? It is the FA Cup at Fratton Park. It's City, it is Portsmouth, it's Pompey. It's the Pompey Fire. What a way to make a statement of our intent and to go and beat Man City at home. I highly doubt it. But score prediction in the chat, on the legendary. It's like playing squad battles right now. A very pumped up side versus a side of not as good a quality. And off we go. We're in to that 4-1-2-1-2 narrow. We have a 3-3 from Wayne Danger in chat. I don't know. It might be a 3-3. Anyway, Clark on the ball. Inside there. What more? Close. Good ball. Low. Can we score from kickoff maybe? Ferreira. Ball in. Oh, it was there. It was needed to be played. Could have gone the other way too. In the end, it is 0-0 still from kickoff. But 3 minutes gone. Ferreira. Ball in there. Harper. Touches in. Curtis tries to come inside, won't. In the end, it will be there. And this is their first time on it. Phil Foden, who probably grew into a freak on career mode. I don't know if Standler is in Nyambe. Foden again on it. And this is where is the difference between playing teams in our side and teams in Man City. A, the ball falls back to them when you do press. But B, just look how quickly they move it around. You know, coming inside, good ball movement. Should be able to deal with that. And Lopez, who is in goals and is well on his way to completing, I think he's completed his 5 games, is definitely our best keeper, and away we go. Apparently, Mahrez is the player to watch. I would agree. Mahrez is really good. I have his second in form on Ultimate Team, and it does the job. Anyway, Ferreira. Well, I did do the job, but don't use him anymore. Foden. Steward Foden. All the way back. Can we get out wide? Murick in goals. don't know who Murick is. I'm surprised Edison isn't playing. Maybe they're resting players. That's good for us. Oh, where they're Sernberg, I can never pronounce his name, but the Dutch guy that goes into a freak. He's got the number 9 on, which shows you how much potential they reckon he has. Anyway, the ball there, played in Felipe Luiz, and a possession-hungry Man City side. Can we get that away? We do, but falls back there to Berg. Come on, can we get that away? We try to. Falls back to Luiz. Good flick inside. Jesus, look how well they're keeping it. Top of the box. Chip, scissor kick. In the end, Foden's offside. But welcome to Legendary, ladies and gentlemen, when you play against a really good side. They pressed us up very high, too. In the end, a risky pass. And somehow there's a free kick up top. I don't know what that's for. Anyway, cleared. Clark. Good amount of pressure being put on here from City, but we do get out of that press, and maybe we can go forward here. Ferreira, Evans, overlapping run. There's a ball in. Can we come inside? We do. Big chance, Evans. Oh, Murick, what a save. It was a massive chance with Pompey there. Murick makes a great save. We're going to drill that one in there and see how we go. It's a decent ball in. Ferreira cleared. I thought it went in for a second. I thought it was saved, and then I thought it went in when I saw the net bulge, but there we go. Not too bad. In the FA Cup here, round of 32, City gave him the early possession and chances, but we've come away pretty good here in the end. Ball. Can we keep it there close? He does. Good close control from close. The ball there. Curtis. Oh, it was on, but it doesn't fall to him. Just needed a better pass. And look at that ball out. The Bird. Good ball down the line. Jesus. And here come City. Can we get on there? Good ball inside. And there we go. Ilara. He has a go. That's not going to work. And 30 minutes in, we are still 0-0 here, which is not too bad. We'll take that. Good ball from Watmore. Finding feet, he does. And there we go. The overlapping run there. Ferreira comes inside. Does Lowe want it? There's space on the other side. Can we drill this cross in? Take a touch. Drill it in back stick. Oh, nearly. Headed down. Lowe. Worked it there with Harper. Lowe. Not much on. They've now set up really well. They're good banks here. There we are. The ball in. Curtis. Oh, what a challenge. Curtis got goal side, and if that hits his foot, that's a first-time finesse, and that's in. In the end, Portsmouth doing all right. You know, we're holding our own here as Fjordan gets on it, and that's got to be Brown. Well done, son. And away we go. Are we going to have, like, our... I don't know if it goes straight to penalties. Like, on Football Manager, it'll go to a replay. I wonder if it goes to a replay here. If it goes to a replay, you'll see it in this episode. We won't even focus on transfers. Anyway, Stones, though, on that ball. Ilara, still on it. Good ball through again. Anyway... Back into Bergs. Good tackle from Watmore. Can he get rid of it? He doesn't. Falls to Ilara. His ball in. Can we get rid of that one now? Just find his feet. We don't. Oh, that's 1-0. There you go. When you can't get rid of the ball, falls to him once. We try to get it away there just to his feet. We can't. Falls to him again. And Mahrez was going to score. We're 1-0 down now. And there we go. You can't do that on Legendary. We've had a couple of moments. You know, had a big chance early doors too. And in the end, that's not going to find Curtis's feet. And it's going to be City again. We can't afford to go 2-0 down, or else it's pretty much game over pretty quickly. Felipe Luiz, good tackle there. And it falls back to Luiz, though. Far out. Difference between Legendary against a really good side and Legendary against one of the sides in League One. And they've carved us up here again. In the end, Watmore does well. And it falls back to him again. And there our Berg. Well done there by Lowe. And it's half time. I was about to say, we're on the break there. And if we blew for a free kick, I was going to get upset. Fulham are beating Preston in the other game. We look at the match facts. You know, 2 shots won, 3 shots won. Pretty even game in terms of statistics. But City have the edge. Can we find a goal here in the second half? Hopefully we can. We don't want to concede from kickoff. Close. Good tackle, but it falls back to him again. And there we are. Good ball. Mahrez. Still with Mahrez. Can we win that? We don't. What more? Can we press up? We don't. Good ball. Well done, Harper. It's into the hole. Evans. Curtis, Ferreira. It's not going to bounce his feet. Just need that pass. Evans again. Ferreira. Don't run away. Why are you running away for? I want you to play so narrow. I've got it on like too narrow. Good ball up. Low. Oh, just find his feet. Passing's gone out the window here from Portsmouth, and it's all City. We can't afford this. We can't panic. We have to play our football. Play our big possession game. Backstick, they've got one on there. It's Mahrez. Can we stop the supply? What more? Doesn't do enough. It's going to be a corner. It's not looking good at the moment. It's not looking good at all. I'm not going to go to the short. If they want to go short, they can go short. I don't really care. They whip it in. It's going to be headed away. I'm headering it out the other fucking side of the fucking world. Typical legendary. Watch him score from this set piece. Silver beats one. Can probably put in a good ball. He does. Cleared away. Falls back to him again. Huh. Falls back to... Thank Christ. Lopez rolls it out. Not much on there for Brown. Has to go in between the lines. First time there in the Ryan. Come on there. Low. Why can we not make a pass all of a sudden? Press circle to fucking standing tackle. Press circle to standing tackle and bang. Wow. Gotta make a change here. I'm gonna get Solomon in there. We're going to get close off and we're gonna move Harper into there. Get a little bit of speed on either central midfielder role. And away we go. I might even get Cannon off at some point and get Low out wide. And away we go. How are you, Nathan? Good to see you. Been streaming the last few days. Can he get up? We're not. Can it get out of play? It won't. Berg's done well. And it's our ball out wide. We're gonna make that change. Come on, Cannon. In there to Low. Good ball in the feet. Play it. Bounce it. Ferreira. Look at the run. Little dinky chip. Oh, that's a poor cross. And then whoever... Curtis, just stand there. We've had our slight moments, but we can't find that clear-cut chance. Berg's got to get on it. We've gone like full press two now. Come on. Let's keep going. Hold on there. Good tackle. And away we go. Stood him up well. Got to get that ball forward. Solomon wants. Instead, it's the Curtis. If he can get there, I don't mind. He won't. Whoever that is strong and does the job. But we win the ball back. Solomon wants it inside. There's Solomon. There he is. Can we find a crossing opportunity? We're not going to get one from there. But Solomon comes inside. Play it back to Solomon. Into there. Can we go top of the box? We do Harper. Top of the box again. Ferreira. Oh, it's wrong side of him. Can we work something? Ferreira. Oh. Big moment, 75th minute, we're going to make a change. Lowe's going to come in as a marauding fullback. I'm going to move him up the field. As a right wing back. Brown's going to get a bit more further forward too. It's a left wing back. We're going to try and try and try. We're going to get Cannon in there. And Vaughan's known for a late goal. And at least Vaughan has a little bit of headering ability too. We're going to chuck him up there too. 75th minute here in the FA Cup fourth round, you know, round of 32 is what it says in the game. So I think it's the fourth round. And off we go. Can we stop them getting a short one out? We try to. Ferreira, can he get up? He does. Falls there. Oh, man. De Bruyne are too good. And we need that ball back before time ticks away here. Silva now. Good ball into the channel. And this is where space will open up for them. Kun Aguero. Good ball in there. Solomon. Touch. Nice. Evans can run forward now. Third man running. Ferreira wants it. Go Ferreira. Get there, my boy. Skin him alive. Come back inside. Back stick. That's a poor ball. Can Solomon take a good touch? He does. In the end, it's cleared. And not only going to be, though, as far as Jamal Lowe. He's got numbers inside. Chipped at top of the box. The ball through. Vaughan's on. No. Oh, would have been a chance to be a hero. They've gone again. Ferreira, get up. Doesn't win that one. Come on, boys. Jamal's still on that line. We're going to win the throw. That's fine. Come on. We need one now. Now or never. May. Oh, that's poor. What a big chance. Can we get up? We don't get up there. Can we get on the press? We don't. They're going to get out here. Time's going to tick away very quickly because we're only on 4 minutes. Harper. Come on, we need to buzz around here. They win it again and again. Come on. We need that ball. We need it now. City holding it well in the corner flag. 2 minutes out of time. We need it. We need it now. Ball in. Effort. Lopez corner. All right. It's probably going to be game over from here. I'm just going to run whoever this is out the box. If they go short in time waste, I will cry. Lopez, I need you. Punches. It's game over. Oh, we're out of the FA Cup. Vaughan misses a clear cut late chance. And we nearly drag a replay against Manchester City. This big miss from Vaughan. We cut them up after the ball. Get recycled. 1-2. Great ball inside. Vaughan first time. And that should have been 1-1. Like, I don't know how Vaughan has put it wide. Especially with first time shooting being OP. In the end, though, we don't get through to the next round of the FA Cup. Arguably had the better of the game, but very, very even indeed. Even a legendary run, Man City, very close. But unfortunately, our FA Cup run is going to end here. For everybody on YouTube, though, we are going to recap all the transfers that we do make on deadline day and so on in just a second. So don't go anywhere. I'll see you guys for the transfer drama that will unfold in the not-too-distant future. Welcome back, YouTube here. It is now the transfer time of it. And Jackson Irvine is a guy that's been on my list. A, he's Australian. Secondly, centre attacking mid. We have Evans, he's in great form, don't get me wrong, but Jackson Irvine is obviously a better player and can play centre attacking mid, centre defensive mid, and according to FootWiz, after we're having a look, he can also play striker, left back, right back, and centre back. All at 70 rated. It's pretty good. I don't expect Irvine to ever grow past the 70s, to be honest, but this is a guy that we can use in the championship and, you know, be obviously of a very good level in the championship and impact games in the championship. And when we get to the Premier League, probably sell on for roughly around the same price as long as we don't take 5 or 6 years to get out of the championship. So this is a guy we're going to go and negotiate a deal with and see. Now, he does represent a large percentage of our transfer budget. Our transfer budget of about 3 mil. He was worth 3.3, and they ended up accepting 2.8 and 10% of his next sell-on fee. So, be interesting to see how we go here with negotiations here. Let's start with negotiations, and he's going to be a crucial part of the first team. How does that work? That's great. Good, Jackson. Making good progress. Now, let's agree on how many years he wants to sign for us. I want him here for 4 years and see what they say to that. My client is happy. I only want to be here for 2 years. All right, we'll accept 2 years. And we'll continue on. Disregard release fee. It's talking of money. He's currently on 20k wage. I didn't know that. That's a big wage, Jacko. That's a fair offer. My client's happy with 20k wage too. Boom. Jackson Irvine's in. All right. Not a problem. Didn't even have the loan ball. We got Jackson Irvine in. And he's going to slot straight in. If we go to the Portsmouth squad, we go into Evans, who's at 66. Evans now makes his way to the bench, and we are going to take Pittman out because I don't really like Pittman. We're actually going to transfer this Pittman, and we are going to put Jackson Irvine in the middle of the hole. And all of a sudden, our team on paper looks pretty damn solid. Like, Evans off the bench to impact the game, Jackson Irvine in behind, you know, all of a sudden, you know, in the, especially here in League One, this team looks pretty good. Anyhow, YouTube, I'll see you guys on deadline day to probably wrap up any more transfer drama that may or may not have happened. Welcome back, YouTube, here on deadline there. Hardstrap has an offer here at the end. Hardstrap's 22 at 63 overall, but has a little bit of potential and is not a bad backup player. They're currently offering, you know, 600, which is what his value is. I'm not interested in selling him this year. Next season, yeah, 100% sure. And plus, he's coming back from long-term injury. But if he can get to 66, 67, he's going to be quite useful for us in the championship. So I am going to reject that offer there. But we do have a second offer coming in, and I have transfer listed Pittman because we just signed Irvine. And he's got an offer from Trina there for 790. He's currently worth 925. I am going to try and negotiate this for about $1 million, I reckon. If I can get a mil for him, I'll be pretty happy. So off we go. Hopefully to make a sale here and recoup some of the money we just spent on Irvine. Propose a new transfer fee. Let's go and try and get 1-1. And not less than to take less than 1-1. Okay, they want to just give us one straight out and a sell-on fee. I'm happy with that. Unreal. So they're giving us £1,050, I think. Oh, £1,050 and a sell-on fee. And there we are, 50,000. There we go. But there we are. Pittman there now. Going to get sold out, hopefully. We are going to sim forward the next day until it is 100% done. And hopefully, in the end, we'll be A-okay. Off we go. And has Pittman been sold? We have an offer from Rayo Oviedo now for Pittman. Here we go. So Oviedo coming in. We're going to negotiate that with Oviedo now. And here we go. A little bit of transfer drama going on here on deadline day. And hopefully we can able to get what was worth through. All right. So we're going to try and propose a new fee there. And we're going to try and get 1.2. See if they want to take 1.2 here on deadline day. They want 920. We obviously got 150 for the last one. So I'm going to offer 1 and see if they're going to come in. 1, 120. This is as much a winning commitment to play. Counter then, propose a new transfer fee. Gonna ask for the exact same offer and see if they give it to us. And if they do, then there's at least two clubs that could sign Pittman. This is our final answer. I'm sorry, we're gonna end negotiation. And there we are. So we don't get the money that we want from Pittman there. Would probably still would have been smart to accept it, because getting 900k for Pittman wouldn't be the worst. But I'm hoping he does leave. In the end, time ticking away here. No negotiation or offer from Pittman. No offer on anyone else either yet. Pittman still hasn't left the club. If you actually, can we see Pompey here? Let's go to Pompey. But it's only going to tell us our transfers from here at the moment. Find out now. Portsmouth there. Yeah, it's just telling us that we've sold Irvine. We've brought in Irvine and that. It hasn't told us about our January window. Pittman has officially now been sold though. Pittman goes, you get 750k back in balance from what we signed Irvine for. And we got big players out. I reckon that's going to be the window. What we are going to do is we're going to sim down till deadline day ends. I don't have to sign anyone else. I'm happy with what I got. I ended up getting Irvine in. That team looks really good. There's a lot of young players there, like Jamal's there, Curtis is there, Harper, Close, Ferreira. I could maybe sign another striker. And there we are. Yeah, Cavani just went to United for 80 million, which is not too bad. Top deals there in the bottom quarter. Rakitic there. PK's gone to Juve. Rakitic has gone to Spurs. But that's going to be our little bit of drama done. Now, the board aren't going to be happy I didn't sign a first-team striker. But when you have Ferreira, who's banging goals and is 70-plus rated already at 17, I'm pretty happy with how things have gone here. Look, that team on paper looks absolutely amazing, and that is what I care about. Anyway, that's going to be the end of Pompey Fight and episode 5 of the Pompey Fight. Next time I see you guys will be for a crunch game coming towards the closing end of the league. As you can see, we're currently top by a point in the league there as well, but with a game in hand. So obviously, we're still tracking quite well to hopefully win the league, which is what the board wants and what we want here as well. Anyhow, until next time, links in the description below. Come for us live on Twitch, which we're currently live on. There's also links there to our Discord and, of course, to our Twitter. And, of course, subscribe and please like the YouTube video as well. And I'll see you next time for more of the Pompey Fight.